Okay, so we're playing Lego Star Wars, the complete saga. It like came out in like 2007, but it's like still like the best game ever. I played it like every day back like 9 years ago or something. My friend bought it for me on Steam, so so we're playing it.
Look, Mom, I know how to use a lightsaber. Are you proud of me yet?
Chapter 1, Negotiations.
So, Ki-Goon-Jin and Obi-Wan Kenobi are being sent to a planet to negotiate, I think. I think that's how it went in the movie. Oh, and it looks like those two guys died. I guess you could say that it was a trap. Apparently I'm 5 episodes early. Okay. So they told us to wait here, so that's what I'm gonna do, so. Okay, this is boring, let's break some things. Look, I'm making these chairs dance. And I broke the door. Oh no, it's bad boys. Oh, hey, it's the C-3PO guy again. Apparently he can open doors. Oh, okay. That's cool. Hey, just open this one as well. Yeah, thanks. Oh no, there's too many of them. What are we going to do? Oh look, it's performance enhancing drugs. Oh shoot, the Rolly Boys are here. So Ki-Goon-Jin and Obi-Wan Kenobi, they just get onto a shoe and they just roll with it, I guess. So I usually take like 30 minutes on that level, so you could say that
the negotiations were short.
Okay, so now we're moving on to chapter 2, which is it's the one with Jar Jar, so brace yourselves. So Ki-Goon and Obi-Wan, get off the shoe. So the space terrorists proceed to commit mass genocide to these innocent troops, as well as blowing up a shoe. We observe the Gungan in its natural habitat. Oh wait, what the heck? The man just- Oh wait, this isn't part of the programming, what the fu- After saving Jar Jar Banks, Ki-Goon realized that he messed up.
Mesa Dupa Haya!
Wait, is that a Jar Jar face? Fight those guys. Oh look, Jar Jar committed suicide. That's great. Oh wait, they're gonna follow him? What the heck? So Ki-Goon uses his GD mind tricks to convince weird-headed guy to let them use a boat with tentacles on it. Okay, time for chapter 3, whatever it's called. So the shoes invade. And then they arrest Queen Amygdala. But then Ki-Goon and Obi-Wan come and save the day. So Amygdala and the other dude have to escape by themselves because Ki-Goon and Obi-Wan left apparently, and I don't know where they went. What the heck? Wait, you had a grappling hook. Why didn't you use that to escape from the castle? Oh, so they're more Jedi. Freaking where they were before on a smoke break? So the space terrorists have killed dozens of innocent droids and now have escaped with the Queen. Alright. So, we're moving on to the, it's the frickin' pod race, oh my god. So apparently the part they need is 500 cents, so apparently, Ki-Goon can't afford it. It's 500 cents. It's $5. So this random kid who's just sitting on the counter, the freaking slave, his name's freaking like Anakin Skywalker. He just like, oh wait, there's a pod race. It's 500 cents. Like, I'll win you $5 if I win the pod race. Like, why are you racing for Ki-Goon? Like, you don't even know Ki-Goon. Like, you just saw him walk in, and he has, like, a nice robe and everything, and you're racing for him? What the heck? Oh, also, this kid's absolute crud at racing. What the heck? Like, he's running into all the freaking mud pits and everything, and he's freaking... Like, look, he's freaking running into the walls, he's getting hit by the Tusken Raiders. Like, oh my god! Like, his ship just blew up! His freaking ship just blew up! Okay, so while Watto was watching the pod race, Obi-Wan and Ki-Goon just, you know, stole the part and just now they're running away. And hold the phone, is that Anakin? Why is Anakin on the ship? How did he get onto the ship? He sneak off like his ship just blew up and now he's on the ship, like what the heck? Alright, so I'm calmed down, so time for the next one. I don't know what it's called, but yeah. So the Gungan guy agrees to be allies with Padme. So it's like the Battle of Hastings here. Like, they've got a shield. Now the droids are they're firing shots at them. It's not going through the shield. So the droids send the shoes over. So the shoes begin to attack. And then they send out a bunch of more droids, and then the Gungans are getting ready. They're prepared for all-out warfare. This is like the battle of the century. Meanwhile, they're like launching an attack inside the droid headquarters. At first, it was like a stealth mission, but then they got the guy to shoot the boy. Like, you guys lost their stealth. Now all the droids are gonna get onto you. Like, what was the point of that? Like, what? Why didn't you just go charge in if you were gonna do that in the first place? Like, come on, man. Oh, never mind. It looks like they actually are charging in. Okay, so they're gonna fight. So they're just gonna ignore all the troops and just open the door and then just walk it. Like, what? How? Okay. Oh, and there happens to be exactly 6 pressure plates for them to open the door. Like, oh wow, plot convenience much? Oh shoot, the droids have captured all of our guys. Oh no, what are we going to do? I mean, they're just 6 guys. It's not like it really mattered. It's not like they had like any importance in the plot or anything, so. Alright, so it's the mall fight. Hopefully no one dies or gets chopped in half. It's over, Obi-Wan. I have the high ground.
You underestimate my power!
And then Ki-Goon died, so, yeah. And then the galaxy lived happily ever after. Well, at least until this little twat grew up.